A calm Wednesday afternoon with residents going about their duties normally. This is the densely populated community in Banda, a suburb in Kampala's Nakawa division. But in a split of a second, the calm here could be interrupted for the worst. Thousands of lives could be lost, and this community wiped off the face of the earth. The fallout would be a story which would redefine Uganda's history. Such an explosion is imminent with the Mogas Fuel Reserves located in the heart of Banda, side by side with many homesteads, businesses, and Chambogo University. The residents are worried that it's just a matter of time before this ticking time bomb goes off.
Tanka senge ya bikabwiti twaba no muntu no mwakola ki asigala
ngavola ba mogasweri tubera mukutia.
But for others, the long passage of time seems to have eased their fears. Oblivious of this life-threatening situation, the residents claim they are ready for any eventuality. They claim to have raised the matter to the relevant authorities in vain. But how did such a huge fuel reservoir end up in the midst of residences near a university and next to a road? We set out to investigate the story behind Mogas Uganda fuel reservoirs in Banda. Our first knock was at the door of Partha Ghosh, the managing director of Mogas International. The Ministry of Works and Transport owns the land on which the fuel complex sits and beyond. But a few years ago, Mogas Uganda acquired a 99-year lease for it.
To get a permission to set up this kind of storage, you need to go and seek permission from the relevant government authorities.
In December 2009, the defunct Kampala City Council, KCC, cleared Mogas to set up the fuel reservoir after the company presented its investment plan and blueprints. Later, KCCA's successor, Kampala Capital City Authority, KCCA, also stamped the project.
They got a commencement letter in 2009, and then in 2013, they got an approval for this facility to be in this particular place.
KCCA officials told NTV that the area in question was gazetted as an industrial zone and not residential. Mogas Uganda Limited MD Partha Ghosh explains that the company compensated all the residents then occupying the land.
For the purpose of improving safety and security of this establishment, we settled people on the road reserve, which is on the Jinja Road side, and also settled people behind and down our boundary wall in order to improve the safety zone.
NTV also found that the Ministry of Energy and Mineral Development cleared the construction of the fuel complex.
By the time I did the approval, I certified myself that they have met the requirements.
Once Mogas secured clearance from KCCA and the Ministry of Energy, environment watchdog NEMA was next. But NEMA also gave the green light to the investment.
All the environment issues that were likely to arise were mitigated.
With all the relevant authorities giving no objection, Mogas proceeded to begin operations. The tanks behind me have about 4 million liters of fuel, ranging from petrol, kerosene and diesel. And in case of a fire, the impact can be so immense that thousands of lives can be lost and businesses worth billions turned to ashes. The management here says that they are putting in place all safety precautions to ensure that a fire does not occur, and in case it does, it can be contained.
High quality flame and explosion proof firefighting pump. We have got sprinkler system, very effective. We have got automatic cutoff switch. We have got a generator that in case the power goes, it will automatically switch on. We have got a serious security system, the cameras, the everything of the highest standard.
Mogas claims to have invested more than $70,000 approximately 180 million shillings to put in place safety measures to prevent an explosion or mitigate disaster.
There is no chance that this can explode.
Nevertheless, the safety of the residents here remain in balance. Solomon Serwanja, NTV.